Welcome back to Trigonometry. This is part 6. In this video, we are going to learn how to determine the general solution of a trigonometric equation. Very important question. Determine the general solution of sine theta equal to half. I'm giving you a simple equation now to explain the method how to get the general solution of trigonometric equations. The first step is to get the reference angle on the calculator. So how do we get it? We use second function sine of the number. What is the number? Half. We get 30 degree on the calculator. Okay, even if the number is minus half, on the calculator, when we take the reference angle, don't consider the minus sign, only the positive number. So second function sine half is 30 degree. That is called a reference angle. We can even call it calculator angle. Okay, so we take that. Now we look at the question. Sine theta is equal to positive half. Okay, that number is very important. If it is a positive number, the quadrant is decided according to the sine of the number. Now, sine theta is positive where? In the first and in the second quadrant. That we have to decide. Now, we calculate the general solutions. In the first quadrant, we already know that it is acute angle. That is 30 degree. We write the answer very quick. Reference angle plus. Look at that one. You must mention when you have questions on general solution. For sine and cos, you write k times 360, multiples of 360. And what is this k? K represents the integers in the number system. Minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, etc. So you can have any number for k. And now look at this question. Theta is 30 degree plus k times 360. If you choose k equal to 0, k equal to 0, 0 times 360 becomes 0. So we get one answer, 30 degrees. That is the solution. If you choose k equal to 1, 1 times 360, that is 360. So 360 plus 30 is 390. Okay, that is another answer. If you choose minus 1, you get on the calculator. Don't waste your time. Just use the calculator. You get all the values. Now, if the question is to solve the equation, not the general solution, you have to write all those answers in the interval. If the question is between minus 180 and 180, you write, you choose only the numbers inside the interval. Okay, so that is the method. Now let us go to the second quadrant. Okay, we have second quadrant here. How do you get the answer in the second quadrant, angle in the second quadrant? 180 minus our reference angle, that is 180 minus 30. We get 150 plus, you write k times 360. Okay, that one is said represents the set of integers. Okay. Again, determine the general solution of tan 2 theta. Okay, again, I am giving you a simple equation to explain the method. Find the reference angle. What did I say? Don't consider the negative sign. Only positive 4 on the calculator. So reference angle, second function tan 4, 75,9637. That is the number you get on the calculator. That is our reference angle. Now question, tan 2 theta is negative 4. Where is tan negative? Which quadrant? Decide now. Second and fourth. Now write the answers. Quadrant 2. Okay, 180 minus 75 comma, but our question is to write the general solution, that is theta. We must get theta now, divide by 2. The right hand side must be divided by 2, including k times 180, divide by 2. We get k times 90. Don't forget, these are all marked. Quadrant 4, 360 minus. Simplify on the calculator. you get 284. Divide by 2, again on the calculator. Okay, and that is how we answer these type of questions. Now we come to the examination room. Determine the general solution of sine x plus 25 cos 15 minus cos x plus 25 sine 15 equal to tan 165. Even the right hand side, you are not given the number. Look at the left hand side, compound angle, okay, sine alpha cos beta minus cos alpha sine beta. What is that? We simplify it. Sine of alpha minus beta. So there we start. And on the right hand side, we have tan 165. We use the calculator and get the value. So we can write sine alpha minus beta. What is alpha here? X plus 25. What is beta? That is 15. So x plus 25 minus 15. And on the right hand side, use the calculator and get tan 165. We get a number negative 0,2679. Okay. Then we simplify the bracket. 25 minus 15 is 10. So sine of something, that is what we want. Either sine of an angle equal to something, cos of an angle equal to something, or tan of an angle equal to something. Until then, if the question is tricky, we will modify the question and simplify, get it until we get this step. Now we move on to that reference angle on the calculator. We get 15,5393, second function tan, don't use the negative sign, only 0,2679. We get 15,5393 on the calculator. Where is tan negative? In the third and the fourth quadrant. Okay, we continue. Quadrant 3, 180 plus. Use the calculator. And then you minus 10 there, x equal to. Okay, write k element of z. Quadrant 4, 360 minus reference angle. Simplify using the calculator. Then subtract 10, we get 334,46. Okay, so that is the method, good people. By now you know how to answer these questions. Let us look at more questions now. Determine the general solution of 2 sine square x plus 3 sine x minus 2 equal to 0, a quadratic equation. We don't have sine x equal to a number here. So what we do? We factorize this quadratic equation and get the equation, simple equation. Now, how do we factorize? We can think about K method. Okay. We can write the K method and solve for K. The two answers, K equal to half or K equal to minus 2. Then we can use that idea here. So we have sine x equal to half. What about the other one? Sine x equal to minus 2. No solution. Okay. You can also check on the calculator. There is no solution for that. Okay. Now we continue with sine x equal to half. The method, reference angle, we got 30 degree. Then quadrants. What are the quadrants? Positive half, first quadrant and second quadrant. So first quadrant answer is here, 30 degree plus k times 360, finished. And also second quadrant, 180 minus reference angle. We get 150 plus k times 360. And at the end, we write k element of z. So if the question is not straight, we will modify, okay, until we get sine x equal to something or cos x equal to something. Calculate the general solution of theta where sine theta not equal to 0 and 1 minus cos 2 theta equal to 8 sine theta sine 2 theta. Double angle question. Okay, we are doing only good questions here. By now, you know how to get the general solution. But if the question is not giving us cos theta equal to something or sine theta, we will modify. We will use our previous knowledge of double angle here Let us start. What is cos 2 theta? 1 minus 2 sine square theta. We have three options, but we choose 1 minus 2 sine square theta. Here, sine 2 theta, only one option, 2 sine theta cos theta. Okay. So we are going to simplify this question. Left hand side, right hand side, you substitute. In the place of cos 2 theta, we replace inside the bracket because we do have a minus sign outside. Remember, and sine 2 theta is 2 sine theta cos theta. Left hand side simplified, 2 sine square, 1 minus 1 cancelled. Right hand side becomes 16 sine square theta cos theta. Okay, again, we have to try and get the simplest factors now. Here is 2 sine square theta minus 8 sine square theta cos theta equal to 0. Factorize. Okay, we have to factorize now. 2 sine square is common, 1 minus 4 cos theta. Okay, so we have two factors here, sine square theta equal to 0 or 1 minus 4 cos theta equal to 0, but we are given that sine theta not equal to 0 in the question, so we ignore from there. Let us go to the other factor. We get minus 4 cos theta equal to minus 1, cos theta therefore equal to 1 over 4, and now we have the simplest equation. What is our reference angle? Second function cos 1 over 4 giving us 75.5. That is the angle in the first quadrant times or plus k times 360. The angle in the fourth quadrant 360 minus, okay, which is 284.5 plus k times 360, where k element of is. Good people, that is how we score the 6 marks of general solution question, sure question on your paper. Okay, master so many questions from the question papers. You work out as many questions as possible. So we learned how to determine the general solution. We started with simple equation, then we came to complicated, beautiful questions. Okay, now you practice more questions. Good luck.